Hey, yo, Shalom, Israel. All praise to you, how about Shem Yahu Shai? Double honor to the apostles and elders, a great millstone, man. Salutations and Shalom to all the Akiyam out there doing the work in sincerity and in truth. Just going to be just going into, I've got two articles here, which are basically just, you know, an update on the microchip, the RFID chip, which is the mark of the beast according to the Bible, man. And, you know, just going to, it's just, Two different articles on technologies that just show they're pushing towards a chip. First one's on CBS Global Local says, could a birth control app replace the pill? It says Natural Cycles is the first app approved by the European Union as a contraceptive. The product is the brainchild of Alina Berglund and her husband Raoul Schoetzel. The Swedish particle physicist was part of the Nobel Prize-winning team that discovered the Higgs boson. She told CBS 11 via Skype that Natural Cycles' discovery was personal. I was searching myself for a hormone-free contraceptive method, but I didn't find any good products on the market. The app relies on a woman's temperature using a 2-decimal basal thermometer, more sensitive than a regular fever thermometer. A woman takes her temperature first thing in the morning. She enters it into the app and an algorithm returns either red or green day reading. Green day means a risk of pregnancy is low. A red day reading means there is a risk of pregnancy. On those days, women relying on the app for contraception should use another form of birth control or abstain from sex. It is why Berlung says the app is ideal for women in stable relationships. So basically, they've got an app which says, you know, they're saying it's a form of contraception. And basically it works by, you know, using a thermometer to measure your temperature. So this could be, you know, one more of the technologies that they use basically to fold into the microchip, man. Because this is basically all you have to really do is a thermometer. So they could say, okay, you know, well, we've got this implantable. You get this implantable, there's all these different apps that will work with it. It's amazing. And then just have this as part of it. And these, you know, you start seeing these technologies and basically this is like basically gonna be like biohacking, man. Because it's like all they say is, okay, well, you get a thermometer, you insert this, it can do that and other things. And then you can use it for, you know, birth control, you don't have to be on the pill anymore, this, that. All that BS. And that's pretty much what you see. The thing is all these different technologies you see, and like brothers be putting up videos round the clock basically on all these different technologies that Esau's developing, where you can see down the line this is going to be part of what they use to sell the chip, man. Because I got this other one. This one's on NBC News and the title is Death Soon May Not Be So Final Thanks to These Creepy Technologies. And let me skip down because well, let me start here. It says, if you believe Ray Kurzweil, an outspoken futurist and the director of engineering at Google, computers will soon match the capabilities of the human brain. At that point, our consciousness will become intimately mingled with machine intelligence, leading to a kind of immortality. And that's what, you know, these elites, if you know anything, you've been keeping up to date, these elites, that is basically what these guys are trying to achieve. These guys are trying to use technology and other methods to basically expand their lifespan, man. And, you know, that's why you have film like Get Out, where it's basically about transplanting the mind from one person to another, man. Because these guys wanted that Jake body, man, that blessing. And this is another way, man, basically trying to download people's fucking consciousness onto a PC, man. Esau's trying to do this shit. He said, we're going to become increasingly non-biological to the point where the biological part isn't what's important anymore, Kurzweil declared in 2013 at a conference predicting the world of 2045. Even if the biological part went away, it wouldn't make any difference. So he's saying you're going to go from being part chip to only chip. And that's pretty much, this is what these elites are trying to work towards, man. That fucking, those ultimate, the invincible bodies. And the thing is as well, is that chip is a form of control, man. That's how they're going to use it. There's going to be, it's like in Gamer, the movie Gamer. They had him, what's his name, Dexter had the chip that was basically like the one that sent signals. And then the regular people had the chip that received the signal, man, the chip for the chattel. So that's basically how it's going to run, man. These guys are basically going to have access to the technology to basically use it as over the peoples, man. And these guys and everyone else is going to, they're going to be ruled, man. They're going to be the sheep, all, man. Says, but you don't need to take such speculative leaps to see that the way we deal with death is already in the midst of a wrenching transformation. In 2015, for the first time ever, more people in the US were cremated than buried. It says, crowded urban centers. Well, that shit is just, what the fuck? Oh, that's some fucked up shit. But, I think, oh, okay. Well, okay, I think this bit goes into it as well. It says, do you have a QR code reader on your phone? She asks. A century from now, will anyone even have any idea what that is? That's a key issue for death in the digital age. Software goes out of date quickly, but memorials are meant to last forever. Today, even keeping track of who is here and who is gone is a challenge. At some point, you probably had the unnerving experience of receiving a Facebook reminder to celebrate a birthday of a friend who is no longer alive. A different kind of second life. Entrepreneurs are rushing in to solve this problem of digital death curation. A site called Digital Beyond manages a list of dozens of companies that handle everything from closing out social media accounts and maintaining permanent cloud-based obituaries to create interactive online memorials. And it's funny, because there was an episode of Black Mirror, which was basically about it's like some bitch, her husband died, and then she basically, there was like a program which basically like filtered through all the shitty posts online and all the different apps that he used online, and then basically created an AI that was basically functioning as him. And that's, you know, that's the level of technology these guys are getting. These guys are basically going to be able to use this, all this information people put online to profile them, man. And then basically link that in. And then you can just, these guys ultimately want to take it to the level where they can actually download your brain. But, you know, Law's not going to have them doing that shit, man. Most like, man. These guys ain't going to be downloading no brains, man. Esau's a fucking a crackpot, man. He's a whack job. But that's, you know, you can see this is what these elites are working towards, man. These guys are basically trying to get that ultimate total control through this microchip, man. And they're trying to use that for multiple ends, for the control and for basically to extend their lives. All these different kind of things these guys are trying to get in, man. And, you know, that's why you got to be checking out the news, staying linked in, man. Staying, seeing what's going on in the world, man. Because the guys that basically are saying, if you're trying to say nothing's going on, then you, bruv, you're not paying attention to the news, man. See what's going on in the Middle East? That's heating up again. The fires, Trump's seems to be steaming it up, man. And Russia as well. The shit against Russia, talking about them hacking elections and basically having thousands of Twitter accounts manipulating like the Brexit vote and all these things. Hey, that is going to continue to come to a boil, man. So, you know, we're almost out of here. Let me read this, man. Revelation 13 and 15, it said, and he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, and the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. And he calls of all, both, well, that's what's going on out here, man. Esau's got it basically on a level where it's like, if you're not down with the American way of life, then he's going to bring the full might of his army against you, man, and put you out. And it says, and he calls of all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads. And that's not Christianity. That's not an embargo. That's talking about this RFID chip and the associated technologies, man. The Internet of Things, all these different technologies that they've got. They're going to link them all together. And then that's going to be the mark of the beast, man. And it says, and no man should buy or sell, save he that have the mark, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name. So you're going to need that mark. That's why this this economy is going to go down the toilet, man. It's going to go down a flash in the pan, man. It's going to be gone. And that's what these guys are, you know, if you actually understood how all these prophecies link together, then it's completely evident that it could only be the chip, man. It's RFID technology. But, you know, I'll leave it there, man. Just, you know, another update on the mark of the beast. And that's basically, you know, just, you know, stay up, man. Shalom.